Hey swimmers, it's Celeste from Triathlon Skills and Simple Swims. So I'm continuing on with my breathing sequence. This is going to be part two. Part one, I opened up a whole new can of worms by having you roll up on your back. So I'm just going to kind of touch on this bit about being on your back in the water. Here you see Maureen swimming along. She's just on her back. She did not do the strokes. Okay, so she's just pushed off the wall. She's on her back. And you can see that she's got her hips nice and level with her shoulder. So she's nice and horizontal. She's got her abs drawn in, her glutes are engaged, and she's just kicking along. She's doing great. And then as she lets go of her abs and starts to reach with her head, her spine is really bowing. So as she reaches, she's not engaging her abs, and her spine is really starting to bend as she's reaching up and sinking and creating a lot of drag. Her spine is really bowing. So as she reaches, she's not engaging her abs, and her spine is really starting to bend as she's reaching up and sinking and creating a lot of drag, okay? And you're also just have that plain old, my legs are sinking, you are just sinking, okay? So I'm gonna show you an exercise on the land to help you take care of that, and then your job is to apply it into the water. Continue with your three strokes and your three breaths. When you're back, practice this, drawing in, engaging your glutes and abs so that you're nice and horizontal, that you don't feel like you're sinking while you're trying to breathe, and then continue on with your next thing. Okay, getting down on the floor, as I always love to do, dry land stuff so that you can kind of focus on that without worrying about trying to get a breath or feeling like you're sinking or any of that stuff. So getting down on the floor and practicing that same posture that you would do in the water by drawing the abs in and adding a flutter kick, okay? So taking one arm overhead, really pressing that lower back down into the floor, drawing the belly button in, engaging the glutes, and then tightening up the quadriceps, and that other hand can just be resting on the side. Okay, so adding some flutter kicks. Okay, if that's too much, then you can also just alternate with the foot on the floor, but be sure that you're really keeping that lower back pressing down. And then we'll change to the other side. And done. Okay, so don't be shy. Take it to the floor before you get to the pool. You don't have to do this at the pool, but this is the kind of core strength that you need for swimming. So drawing the belly button in, engaging the glutes, so compacting those glutes, and keeping those legs really strong and straight. So you're keeping that center nice and stabilized, so what's happening in the lower body and the upper body can be connected in your center. Okay, give it a go. If you like the video, make sure you hit that like button or subscribe. All right, ciao for now.